So, you want to learn how to calculate the weekday of any given calendar date in your head, and you want to be able to do it in seconds. Well, you've come to the right place. Weekday Widget is the fastest and easiest way to learn the human calendar trick, and this tutorial will walk you through the method taught in the app. Let's jump right in by talking about weekdays. Each day of the week corresponds to a number ranging from 0 to 6. Sunday is 0, Monday is 1, Tuesday is 2, Wednesday 3, Thursday 4, Friday 5, and Saturday is 6. If you were to keep counting up from there, you'd see that 7 is also a Sunday, 8 is also a Monday, and so on. We want to stay in the 0 to 6 range, so you'll often be told to mod 7, which means divide your number by 7 and take just the remainder. This is also the same as subtracting 7 over and over until it's less than 7. For instance, 26 mod 7 is equal to 5, since 26 divided by 7 is 3 with a remainder of 5. 13 mod 7 gives us 6, 28 mod 7 equals 0, and 2 mod 7 is, well, 2. Alright, let's start solving for an actual date. What day of the week is August 25th, 1977? First, we need to find our day code, and we get this by taking the day of the month and doing mod 7. 25 mod 7 is 4, so our day code is 4. Easy! Next, we need to add our month code. Every month corresponds to a number from 0 to 6, and you're going to have to memorize all 12 of these to get past this step, but we'll take care of that later. The month code for August is 6, so let's add that to our day code of 4 to get 10. 10 mod 7 gives us 3, which is our day plus month code. We need to remember this number for later, so I'm going to hold up 3 fingers before moving along to the next step. Okay, we're done with the day and the month, so let's look at the year now. Take just the last 2 digits of the year, and we'll do a process called the odd plus 11 method, which goes like this. If the number is odd, add 11. Divide by 2. If the number is odd, add 11. Subtract this number from the next highest multiple of 7. Let's follow these steps with our example year of 77. 77 is odd, so add 11 to get 88. 88 divided by 2 is 44. 44 is even, so don't add 11. The next highest multiple of 7 is 49, so 49 minus 44 equals 5. So the odd plus 11 method for 77 gives us 5. Take note here, you should only ever divide by 2 once. Next, let's take the solution to the odd plus 11 method and add the century code for our year. This might look like more random numbers you need to memorize, but if you're only interested in guessing the weekday of someone's birthday, you really only need to remember the 1900s are 3 and the 2000s are 2. The century code for the 1900s is 3, so 5 plus 3 gives us 8, mod 7 to get our doomsday of 1. Doomsday refers to a bunch of easy-to-remember calendar dates that always share the same weekday, so because the doomsday for 1977 is 1, all of these dates would be a Monday. But we don't really care about that right now. Remember that number 3 from earlier? We're going to add it to our doomsday of 1 to get 4, which corresponds to a Thursday, the day of the week for August 25th, 1977. Nice! Okay, here's the catch. This process will give you the correct weekday for about 96% of all calendar dates. For the last 4%, we need to be aware of a special leap year contingency. If the date is January or February, and on a leap year, subtract 1 from your final answer. Let's do another quick example solve for January 16th, 2020. The day of the month is 16, so we mod 7 to get 2. January's month code is 4, and 2 plus 4 is 6. Assuming you don't have 6 fingers on your hand, you can remember this number for later by sticking out your thumb. Now look at the year. 20 isn't odd, so don't add 11. Divide by 2 to get 10. 10 also isn't odd, so don't add 11. The next highest multiple of 7 is 14, so 14 minus 10 is 4. We're in the 2000s, so add 2 to get our doomsday of 6. Add to this our number 6 from earlier to get 12, and mod 7 brings it down to our final answer of 5, which corresponds to a... Wait! This date is in January, and it's on a leap year, so we need to subtract 1. 5 minus 1 is 4, which corresponds to a Thursday, the day of the week for January 16th, 2020. And that's all there is to it. This method is very similar to the one used by competitive mathematicians, some of whom can find the day of the week in under a second. If you want to try calculating for yourself, go to weekdaywidget.com and try out a few guided solves, which will walk you step by step through the full process. You'll also find mini games to help you memorize the month codes and practice the odd plus 11 method, a speedrun mode you can use to track your progress, a highly configurable practice mode with instantaneous feedback, and many more features that make Weekday Widget the definitive training platform for novice and pro human calendars alike. And did I mention that it's also totally free? Use it in your web browser or follow the instructions on the site to download it to your home screen for offline use. Within about an hour on the app, you'll be spitting out weekdays like it's nothing. This trick might not get you any dates, but the dates you will get are, when the app gives you the dates, you'll get the dates from...